So actually this is a important vibration question. So if you are clear, this is I unknown. If you are clear about moment of inertia, then only you can apply torque method. So that's why moment of inertia is important now. So keep revising moment of inertia idea. So this is your mr square about this line and 3 mr square by 2 about this line. Okay, now I'll go to the question. See the question now. In the question, your disc is rotating about this line, correct? Like every year this line is there. Okay, so like this kind of revolution is coming about this axis. So what will be moment of inertia? First of all, 3 by 2 mr square, no doubt in this. So once you got the moment of inertia, then I have told you how to find out torque, correct? I theta double dot, this is what we have understood in previous class. So this is one torque, means the torque of the disc is going to be I theta double dot. Now you have one more torque. Can you guess what is that torque? Guys, try to guess what is another torque. Anyone? We are total 30. 14 students are missing. Yes. So we have another torque, that is torque of a spring. So we have to know how to find out the torque of the spring. So actually we can find out that because we have done this part. So you can see your spring is attached to a point and about this line, this is your radius and this is your distance A. So about radius, this spring is experiencing torque, right? So try to understand how to find out torque. Any idea you have? Can someone give me the idea? That's all. If you have the idea to find out torque, then you have to add your disc torque plus the spring torque, question over. Then you have to compare with omega theta double dot plus omega and theta is equal to 0. This is going to be your natural frequency. So here theta double dot will come and here theta will come. Compare with omega, question over.